Governor Kim Reynolds is a conservative champion. She signed the heartbeat bill and stands up for Iowans every day. So why is Donald Trump attacking her?
I opened up the governor position for Kim Reynolds, and when she fell behind, I endorsed her, did big rallies, and she won. Now she wants to remain neutral. I don't invite her to events.
Trump should fight Democrats, not Republicans. What happened to Donald Trump? Never Back Down is responsible for the content of this advertising.
Now, Never Back Down is a PAC supporting Ron DeSantis, who of course is running against Donald Trump in the GOP primary. And that particular ad has led to some meltdowns because it turns out that the voice you heard wasn't Trump himself. It was an AI generated version of Trump. But I will say that he actually made that statement about Kim Reynolds. It's just that he didn't say it in an audio recording. With that said though, Trump World did not like the ad apparently, and despite the fact that it was again an actual Truth Social post in which he went after Iowa Governor Kim Reynolds, they're really upset that they fabricated his voice for that political ad. And so Trump campaign senior advisor Chris Lekivita says this: "The blatant use of AI to fabricate President Trump's voice is a desperate attempt by Always Back Down and PAC official Jeff Rowe to deceive the American public because they know DeSanctimonious's campaign is on life support," which by the way, it is on life support.
No, that's
Right about that, yeah.
No, but that's not a message from Trump.
No, it's not.
Other people can't just put that in a message.
How dare you, like, he's appropriating Trump's DeSantis insults.
You used his voice.
How dare you?
That dude is AI.
Okay, so let me continue with the graphic though. "After losing big donors and slashing their staff, they have now outsourced their work to AI just like they would like to outsource American jobs to China." China, okay, so.
Was that AI? That sounded so much like him.
This isn't the first time that the DeSantis campaign has leaned into AI for their political campaigning and their political ads, especially when it comes to attacking Donald Trump. So it wasn't just Trump's team that was upset about this, by the way. Kari Lake wanted to come in and protect daddy. And so she puts out this email, or this message I should say. "Kari Lake calls on all politicians and PACs to pledge against using artificial intelligence in campaign ads," which by the way, I'm not against. I actually think that would be a good rule. Mm-hmm. And I should note that political ads are not regulated by the same, you know, rules that other ads are regulated by. So like false advertising isn't really allowed, right? Mm-hmm. So if there are advertisements that are incredibly misleading or lie about the product that they're trying to sell to you, there are regulations in place to, you know, prevent that from happening and, you know, basically serve consequences when it does happen. In the political realm, lies in political advertising totally allowed. So
I've noticed that.
Yeah, so the infiltration of AI technology in political ads could prove to be disastrous, which is why I get in this context, you might not think it's a big deal, but I do think it's a big deal. And I do think there should be some regulations in place to prevent AI from fabricating things about various politicians candidates.
What about like a compromise? Like, you can do the AI voices, but it has to be as god awful as the AI voice in that ad.
I mean, that was
totally unconvincing.
That was super obvious to us, but is it gonna be obvious to everyone?
I don't know. I will say that as soon as I heard that, I thought like all of the predictions are coming true. AI is taking people's jobs. And I know that because I could have done a much better job. They could have paid me like day rate, 300 bucks, and I could have done that voice and it would have been way more convincing. Anyway, I hate it. I know that like, they very specifically did it off of a quote that existed, mm-hmm. because then they could be like, well, he did actually say it. It doesn't matter. He didn't say it out loud. It's different. You're adding inflection, intonation, that changes it. You can't just do that. And this isn't even the first time that Ron DeSantis has used AI in his ads.
We have another example. And okay, in fact, the example that we're about to show you from last month really upset Tim Pool for some reason. Well, I mean, I haven't seen it. So to be fair, I haven't watched it. Maybe it's particularly egregious. Let's take a look.
Let's see.
You're fired. You're all fired. All four are fired. You're fired.
I didn't want you to.
You're fired. Today I walk walk in, I hear I'm going to fire him. I'm not firing him. I think he's a wonderful guy.
Should you have fired Fauci?
So a lot of people asked me that question, and I did it right. Because if you do fire him, you're going to have a firestorm on the left again.
Why did you feel unable to fire Fauci? Personally, you're not allowed to.
Every time he goes on television, there's always a bomb. But there's a bigger bomb if you fire him.
Frankly, you can't win that one. If I would have done it, I would have taken heat.
Ugh. The crocodile at the end. God, man, do they wish that they had a cooler candidate than they do.
Yeah, I mean, it was labeled where the real Trump was, right?
Well, I mean, but it was like the photos of him literally kissing Fauci on the head. You can't do that.
Yeah, that's true. That's
crazy.
True. Yeah, that's true. I mean, I guess it's because I know how much he despised Fauci, and I know that would have never happened. I would venture to say most Republican voters know that, but who knows? I mean, look. The point here is, people are being misled potentially through the use of this technology, and it's not right, especially in the context of elections.
Well, and also when we discuss the possibility that there could be some sort of regulations, understand that even if we, like, let's say that we agree with Kari Lake or whatever, as we do so often.
On this very specific issue.
Yeah, and on most policies. So if we were to get what we want, we and Kari Lake, I'm kidding.
By the way, don't say that.
I'm like, totally joking.
There's a bunch of leftists from Twitter that are like sitting here watching every single word I say to take out of context
I'm
and
just
claim
joking
that
about
I'm some
Kari
crazy
Lake.
Rabid right winger.
I apologize.
So be clear, we do not support Kari Lake.
I do not like Kari Lake.
Simmer down.
Check the videos.
It's gonna be okay.
I'm not a fan of hers.
Yeah.
But anyway, that's just going to be like the official campaigns. How many thousands of trolls, mostly on the right wing, but perhaps not entirely on the right wing, are desperately looking to use this to inject fake news into the election.
Right.
Like Trump and DeSantis and Biden make a good portion of the stuff you'll see on social media, but you're gonna see a million memes and fake bits of audio and video that are going to flood social media. They're gonna convince tons of people that you know that don't follow politics as much as you do, and will be picked up by right-wing media. You're gonna have shows like Steve Bannon and all of that pretending that they can't tell that this stuff is fake. And so that's my concern, is that even if we succeed in getting some regulations, it's only going to stem the most official stuff.
Yeah, definitely. I don't know how to get around all of the issues we have with misinformation, disinformation, deep fakes, AI. It's just increasingly difficult to ensure that people are informed about what's happening in the country, informed about the candidates that they're about to vote on. And you know, either vote against or vote in favor of. It really is a problem. So in this very minor area, not minor, but this on this very specific issue, there is some agreement between ourselves and people like Kari Lake. I can't believe I'm saying that out loud, but it's true. Intentionally misleading people just to get an advantage in the election is pretty gross. And again, now it's on overdrive considering the technological advancement that makes it possible to lie to people.
Yeah.
But one final thing that I want to say is that apparently the Trump team, you know, likes to fabricate things quite a bit. So here's a tweet from the founder of the Act for America PAC. I mean, this is so obviously fake. It's a tweet showing Donald Trump side by side with Martin Luther King Jr.
Well, that looks pretty real.
That looks very real.
Are you sure? Wait, hold on. Let's fact check the text. Two of our nation's greatest advocates for civil rights. No, I mean, your case could be made. I hate the internet. I hate the internet.
Same.
Whoever that person is, I've seen her tweets because literally right now she's tweeting. She's always tweeting. She does not take time off. Has tons of followers.
Who is
for
that
just
person?
Utter nonsense.
Actually,
after
person.
That tweet, I looked into her. She had written a book that was like super Islamophobic and got some notoriety from that, and now just tweets a lot. I mean, but that describes a lot of people who are for some reason notable in politics. They're just always tweeting.
Yeah, totally. And finally, I didn't hear a lot of brouhaha from the right wing when it came to AI being implemented to smear the left. So it's okay when it smears the left. It's just that they don't like it when it smears Daddy Trump. So here's the example I'm talking about.
Just in, we can now call the 2024 presidential race for Joe Biden.
My fellow Americans,
This morning, an emboldened China invades Taiwan.
Financial markets are in free fall as 500 regional banks have shuttered their doors.
Border agents were overrun by a surge of 80,000 illegals yesterday evening.
Officials closed the city of San Francisco this morning, citing the escalating crime and fentanyl crisis.
Who's in charge here?
It feels like the train is coming off the tracks.
So, John, that was the ad you were referring to earlier.
Yeah. And I love it because it's like, well, we would love to just run on all the stuff Biden has done wrong, but like, I guess we'll just make up stuff and then run against that. That seems easier. Like we talked about this cat turd tweet earlier.
Oh, thank God. Yeah.
Cat turd is constantly retweeting this AOC parody account that says things that like a leftist who is an idiot would say. I love that because like when we want to point out that Marjorie Greene is an idiot, we talk about the things that Marjorie Greene says. When they want to show that AOC is an idiot, they put things that a satirical account like.
That is pretty amazing.
It's kind of demonstrating that you don't have the raw material you wish you did.
Totally, 100%.
Anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't run ads like that. That's insane. There's got to be bounds of reason. I understand that there's some like gray area, like, well, you know, theoretically a person could make art of a thing. Is that really that different? Yes, it's different. You can't do this.
If I ran against Lauren Boebert, all I would do with like zero edits is just use the video of her asking about public urination over and over again as the political ad.
And it's real. That's the benefit.
Paid for by Anna Kasparian PAC. Like, maybe I should run in Colorado. Maybe
move
I should
there.
Consider it.
It's a lovely state.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.